Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about church acoustical design and some of the variables that churches face with, energy inside the church. So what do we have in a church as a source? Well, we have the spoken word, we have the musical word, if you will. And a lot of times all of these are reinforced, electronically through amplification. So we have the spoken word and the musical word, and both of the treatment requirements for each one are quite different. And this is the problem, is trying to get the two scales, the voice and the music, there's just a little bit of area where you can shoot for RT60 times and speech intelligibility times and some overlap there. So that's why it's so difficult with churches to get it right, because the treatment that you use for music is a little bit different than the treatment that you use for voice. So you have to, it's a balancing act, and you have to be able to balance the spoken word and the musical word, so to speak, together. So we have a speech intelligibility and a musical intelligibility issue. Now, there's no such thing as music intelligibility. There is speech intelligibility, but not music. But I'm using it in this way to kind of give you an idea of the two variables that we really have to work with. So we'll keep that in mind. Also, we have low frequency management today becoming an issue in churches. It's normally not that big of an issue because we have lots of volume. However, the stages and churches today, they have a lot of bands. They have a lot of sound reinforcement, electronic amplification. So that just adds more energy to the room. And then you have the choir. They could be up here in a loft. And then you have the congregation, which is down here on the floor. Okay. And they're all singing. The choir is singing. So you have all these sound fields producing energy. Then you could have the stage in the front here with the band and a PA system. You could have all kinds of energy sources within the church. So you have to look at the whole picture. Look at the spoken word and the musical word and figure out what's best for everyone in terms of hearing everything. So low frequency management on the stage is a big, big issue today with churches. A lot of times we build the low frequency management right into the stage itself, so you don't have a lot of freestanding units sitting around. What's our big thing with churches? Well, we have lots of volume. We have big rooms. So we have high RT60 reflection times that we have to work with. So managing those reflections, the most difficult part. And why? Because you got to use either absorption or diffusion technology, and you have to treat surface areas. And most churches, have lots of windows. Okay. And then they have surface areas that they don't want to put treatment on because they like the look of the room itself. Well, it's always a compromise, and you have to blend aesthetics and performance together all the time. So it's just a balancing act. So absorption, probably the most favorite of all treatment, especially when it comes to low frequency management and RT60 times. So absorption is a good technology to use. Diffusion is a great technology on the rear wall of churches to reduce that slap back from that rear wall. Very expensive. Diffusers are not cheap. So most churches opt for absorption. Here's another system we've kind of set up to help churches. We do the design work for them, give them the drawings, define the materials that they have to use, the positions the materials have to be in, and then they usually have church members, members of the congregation who are have woodworking skills that contribute their time and energy to building the units and doing the installation. So there's all kinds of programs that we've been working with churches to help them with this cost, effect. And we can supply you the materials, you supply the labor and the positioning. We do all the design work for you. So there's a lot of variables that we can work with in here to get you what you need. But the intelligibility issue, the RT60 time management, always takes surface treatment, and it's always a give and take. You need to cover so much surface area with so much rate and level of absorption to achieve a particular RT60 time, and that means surface area. So you're going to have to give up some of the surface area in the church to manage the issue so that the spoken and the musical word can be heard. So that's our church acoustical design, kind of in a summary. Let us know if we can assist you with that in any way. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.